Ever wonder how your acts recognize faces or translate languages? What if you could build all this into your app without being an AI expert? Welcome to Azure Cognitive Services, your shortcut of adding intelligence to your next generation apps. So let's dig into it. So today we are going to understand Azure Cognitive Services. Azure Cognitive Services are pre-built APIs that you can easily plug and play into your application. With Azure Cognitive Services, there is no need of training your own machine learning model. You just call an API, and then your application can see, hear, speak, and think. Think of it as a plug and play AI for developers. There are 5 powerful categories for Azure Cognitive Services: Vision Services, Language Services, Speech Services, Decision Services, and Web Search, also known as Bing API. So today we are going to understand all these 5 categories in detail. So let us first start with Vision Services. Azure's Vision API allows your application to see and understand visual data the way humans do. We have various services under Vision Services. We have face detection services, we have object analysis services, we have OCR services, and we have image analysis. What comes under face detection? Face detection services identify faces in images along with their age, emotions, and gender. Object recognition detect and label objects like cars, animals, buildings, etc. OCR, known as optical character recognition, extract text from images or scan documents. With the help of image analysis services, we can get descriptions, text, and even adult content warning. For example, you are building a smart photo application that tags and even blur faces. That is where you can use Vision Services. With the help of speech services, your application can turn spoken words into text and vice versa. Even we can identify who is speaking. We have services like text-to-speech, speech-to-text, and speaker recognition. In speech-to-text services, we can convert spoken audio into written text. And in text-to-speech services, we can read out text using natural-sounding AI voices. With the help of speaker recognition, we can identify or verify who is speaking. For example, you are building hands-free voice assistant like Alexa or Siri. Now we have language services. With the help of language services, your application can understand human communication. We have language translation supports. We can translate into 90 plus languages. We have sentiment analysis, key phrase extraction, summarization, and Q&A. As we see in sentiment analysis, your application can understand the sentiment, the emotions of the statement, like it's a positive, negative, or neutral. It is heavily used when you have a feedback for the product. In key phrase extractions, we extract important keywords, important content from the document, from the text. With the summarization, we can condense a lengthy text into a small summary. And with the Q&A, we can have multi-turn question and answer with the user. So understand the real-time example. So we are running a support center with global customers. We can auto-translate their queries, detect if they are frustrated, and summarize long complaints for faster resolution. Now we have decision services, which helps your application make smart choice and even flag risky or unusual content. See, we have content moderator service underneath it, which automatically filter out offensive or harmful images, videos, and text. We have anomaly detector, which spot abnormal behavior in data, for example, fraud or server issues. We have personalizer services, which gives you recommendation based on user preferences. For example, you are running a content sharing platform, and these community services can flag harmful uploads, detect fraud or personalizations to keep users engaged. Now we have web search. The web search allows our application search the internet like Microsoft Bing does. It is helpful for enrichment of data and to get the live content. With the web search, we get real-time internet knowledge. We can search news, videos, web, as well as images. It is helpful for spell check as well as autosuggest. For example, you are developing a chatbot which gives live news, trivia, or weather information using Bing. Now we see how we can use all these cognitive services in your real-world examples. So we are building an e-learning application. We can use speech-to-text services to transcribe live or recorded classes. We can use computer vision service to scan handwritten notes. We can use language services to summarize chapters as well as to detect the tone. And the best part, you don't need to build AI models from scratch. Just plug in Azure Cognitive Services with a few API calls and you are live. AI is not hard. When next time someone say AI is hard, show them Azure Cognitive Services. No ML degree needed. Just plug and play API to build smart applications.